Within Russia's Kamchatka Peninsula are more than 24 active volcanoes. One of these is highly unusual due to the fact that after it erupts, small diamonds can be subsequently found within its lava flows once they cool. Although these diamonds are almost universally less than 1 millimeter in width, some reports suggest that larger crystals do exist on the slopes of the Avachinsky volcano. For example, here is a photo of the type of diamond found within some of Avachinsky's lava flows. While this does not look like the typical type of often transparent diamond that we know and love, this is in fact a variety of diamond being known as a carbonado. This makes Avachinsky the only volcano in the last 10 million years on the planet known to have erupted diamonds. And carbonado is not the only unusual mineral this volcano produces, as on its edifice can be found a thallium and iodine-rich mineral known as natalyama lekite. These two unusual minerals, although likely unrelated to one another, hint at an unusual geologic setting that might be generating these fascinating minerals. To understand why all this is so unusual, we must first understand how diamonds are traditionally generated and end up on the Earth's surface. Diamonds generally only form underneath sections of the Earth's crust known as cratons, which are unusually thick. Below these cratons and the upper mantle is where diamond generation can begin. There, at a depth of 150 to 200 kilometers, elemental carbon due to intense pressure and heat slowly becomes diamond. Kimberlite magma begins in the mantle, slowly rising shallower into the crust at unusually high speeds due to their gas-rich composition, typically with a high level of carbon dioxide. Along their path upwards, the magma sometimes grabs diamonds deep underneath cratons and carries them upwards. Moving through the crust, the speed of the kimberlite intrusion continually increases, often surpassing a speed of 40 miles per hour, generating earthquakes along the way. In a matter of hours, perhaps even time spans an order of magnitude shorter, the kimberlite intrusion reaches the surface, exploding in a powerful and highly explosive eruption. Although diamonds can be ejected onto the surface during these powerful eruptions, the vast majority of deposits mined today represent highly eroded segments of a kimberlite pipe where the modern surface level was originally located at a depth of several kilometers at the time of the eruption. Looking at Avachinsky, it is clearly not a kimberlite pipe, but rather a stratovolcano. And it has never erupted any form of kimberlite, but rather a variety of lavas which range from picrobasalt to dacite. Although it is unclear exactly how these diamonds formed, it is quite possible that it represents a piece of the mantle which was carried to the surface. Such fragments are termed xenoliths and are frequently found at certain volcanoes, often bringing minerals to the surface such as olivine, whose gem name is peridot. Another possibility is that the original carbonados represent impact diamonds, aka diamonds that formed as a result of a massive asteroid impact. It has been known for some time that certain groups of smaller diamonds can form through this process, such as the Papagai impact crater, which formed around 36 million years ago. Yet, no large impact craters are known or suspected in the vicinity of Kamchatka. And, even if there was one which was simply unknown to science, you would expect to also find diamonds at the adjacent Koryaksky volcano 11 kilometers to the northwest. However, carbonado diamonds are only found at Avachinsky. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new patron, Justin Bickford, for supporting this channel.